Everyone, I'm throwing a little video together for you. Hopefully, if you're struggling with plotting and doing calculations in Excel throughout the semester, you'll be able to come back to this video for a little bit of guidance. Throughout the semester, we are going to be using Excel a lot to do calculations and analysis and plotting. Many of you have never had experience with that or are a little fuzzy, so this is going to help you out. So what I have up here on the screen right now is my Excel with a blank worksheet up and the first week's lab. And I'm going to copy over the data from Table 1 over into Excel because, as you can see, we have to do some calculations in Table 1. When I do that, I want to grab not only the numbers, but I want to grab the column heading. So I'm going to highlight my whole table. I'm going to copy it. I'm going to come over here, click in cell A1, which is just the top of the spreadsheet there, and I'm going to paste it in. Now, a couple of quick things. Most measurements that we do have some type of units. When we're working in Excel, we don't want to put our units next to our numbers because then those numbers become text and you can't do calculations with them. So typically you want to put your units at the column heading, which is what I've done here. Now, transmittance is the first thing we're going to calculate, and transmittance is always transmitted light divided by incident light. The incident light in this situation is the same for every entry we have, which is our number of drops. So we're putting the number, we're putting ink drops into water and measuring how much light comes through on the other end. Now, the incident light going in, we're going to say, was 7,000 lux. I'm just going to type that in there for a reference so we have it, remember it. So as I said, transmittance is transmitted light divided by incident light. So in this case, I need to do this first calculation, and I want it to go in cell C2, column C, row 2. So I'm going to click in C2. Hopefully you can see it sort of highlights a little bit green. Excel is nothing but a ginormous calculator. So if I wanted to do an equation, I'm going to start with an equal sign. In this case, equals. So the transmittance is 4,000 divided by 7,000. And hit an enter sign, and I get 0.5714285711. That is correct. It is, however, a little too big for what we're looking for. Let me go into full screen mode here. Okay. I want to take that down to two significant figures, two non-zero digits after the decimal point. So I would need to change this. I don't want to change it by hand. I want to use these two little functions throughout the year that are in my toolbar. One increases decimals and one decreases. So I'm just going to decrease until I get down to two. The reason I want to do it this way is that it's a referenced number. Well, it's going to be a reference number. So if I can't really type in that cell later, plus it never makes a mistake, and I always do. Now, if I go back to this calculation, I typed in 4,000 divided by 7,000. The next one would be 2,000 divided by 7,000. Next one would be 1,000 divided by 7,000. That is a lot of work, and I could have done that on my calculator and just typed it in. So evidently, there's a better way. So let's start all over again. We're going to start with an equal sign, and rather than typing in the 4,000 this time, I'm going to put my mouse over it, which gives me that reference of B2, and I'm just going to click on it. B2 says I clicked on the value that's in column B, row 2, and now I'm going to divide it by 7,000. Now, some of you might be, 7,000. Some of you might be thinking, why not just tap on the 7,000? And I could do that, but it's a little bit advanced for us right now. It's a constant. It never changes, so I can type it in. I can hit an enter, and you see I get the same number. Now, I could come down here and do the same thing. I could put my equal sign in. I could click on the 2,000. I can divide it by 7,000 then and get my next answer. That's not really saving me a lot of time. It's not the way I want to do it. If I click back up on that first one I did, hopefully you can see that it's outlined in green, and down here is a little handle. When I take my mouse and move over top of that handle, I go from sort of a hollow mouse to a solid mouse. When I'm or a solid mouse icon. When I have that solid, I just want to click on that handle and drag it down my entire table. Now, what happened here? Well, I'm minus a few significant figures, so let me go back up here and expand it a little bit. I'm just going to do the ones that I need to get to the right value. This one needs one more. Now, why did I click on that B2? Well, so down here for two drops, it would be 1,000 divided by 7,000, but I'm going to click in here, and if I click back up here in my formula bar to activate it, it's really cool because you can see that B2 and the cell I'm sorry, the B4 and the cell that is B4 are color-coded. Right now, we only have one variable. Later in the semester, we'll have a lot more. It really helps with debugging when you can activate that cell. But what you should notice is that that is the right calculation. And the reference, when I dragged my cell equation down, that reference, because I was dragging down across rows, the row number incremented. So that saves me a lot of time. Opacity, I guess I'm just going to go the whole way through here because I want to show you a function for density. Opacity is 1 over transmittance or incident light divided by transmitted light, but because we already have transmittance, we're just going to use it. We're going to do that same thing. We wanted to do the math. I'm going to put an equal sign, 1 divided by, and click on transmittance, and then hit enter. And remember, again, I can go, I activate that cell again, I take my mouse, put it over that little handle in the lower right-hand corner, click and drag it down, and my equation goes the whole way down. My decimals aren't quite right, so I'm going to highlight my whole column, and I'm just going to change it, and then change it, click on my decrease, click on my increase to get to the two decimals. These are actually whole numbers, they're going to be zeros, so 2 is fine here. Now, density is the log of opacity. Log is a function. Just like you have a function button on your calculator, you have functions within Excel as well. So in this situation, to get the log of opacity, I'm going to, again, just hit that equal sign. I'm going to click on my opacity, and then, I'm wrong. I'm going to hit the equal sign, and I'm going to type in the word log. Now, you can type it in small, or you can type it in capital. It does not matter. And I'm going to open up parentheses. And I am going to, typically when you're using a function, I guess I should explain this, you get the usage up here. Anything that's in a square bracket is optional. You typically in, well, I shouldn't say you typically, but in this situation, we don't need to worry about it. We just need the number. So I want to take the log of 1.75. I'm going to click on 1.75. It gives me that reference of D2. I am going to close my parenthesis, hit an enter, and I have density. Again, I only need 2 decimal points, so I'm going to use that cool little function to decrease decimals. I'm going to do that same thing. I'm going to click on that handle and drag it down, and now I have my densities. So I have my entire table filled out. So let me go back out of screen, full screen mode here for a second. Now I need to get all these numbers from here over to here. So there's a couple ways to do that. I'm just going to highlight the ones I calculated, and I'm going to copy them. Again, I'm using that keyboard shortcut, Command-C. I believe it's Alt-C if you're on a PC. Sorry about that. I'm on a Mac. Most people are just going to want to come over here and click in Transmittance and do a paste. Well, when you do that, that happens. It throws that entire copied value into that one cell. Not what we want to do, so I'm going to undo that. What I want to do, I highlighted from the transmittance for 0 drops down to the density for 10 drops. I'm going to highlight that same area over here in my table and do a paste. And now I have pasted all of my calculations from my Excel document back into my Word document in the right place, properly rounded, and done correctly. You can never just take an image and paste an image in. When we do our corrections, we actually grab your data, throw it into a spreadsheet, and it tells us if you've done it right. So make sure you always do it that way. The next thing we need to do is to do a plot. Now, this is not the typical way I would tell you to do a plot, but what we need to do is we need a plot of 0 drops versus transmittance. It's a little bit tricky here because I don't really need the one in the middle, and I could copy and paste this data to another place, but what I'm going to do is actually show you the easy shortcut, I guess. I'm going to go from number of drops the whole way down to 10 drops for transmittance. I'm going to highlight those. I'm going to use my insert key, and I am going to insert an XY scatter plot with smooth lines. I don't really need the markers, so I'm just going to click on that right now, and what it hopefully, there it goes, is going to give me a plot of two things. The number of drops is my X data, but I have two Y datas here. I have illuminance, which I do not need, and transmittance, which I do need. The easy thing to do here, just click on that one, on the illuminance curve, highlights it, just hit the delete key, and now you have a transmittance curve. Well, sort of. The nice thing about having those highlights up there, or your heading, your column headings, is when you highlighted them, it automatically makes a legend for you. When you only have one set of data, you don't need that legend, but you're going to need it a lot through the semester. So always want to carry those headings with you. You are, however, missing an X and a Y axis, and we need those. So while I have my chart active, if you notice when I go off of my chart, my menu options up here change. So I'm going to click back on my chart. It's active. You can tell I've got the little marks there. And I want to add some chart elements. And I'm going to add both a primary label down here. I'm going to call that number of drops. And then I need a y-axis. I need it a horizontal axis. And I'm going to call that transmittance. Get rid of what it put there for me. So now I have a plot of transmittance. I need to place that plot into my Word document. And if you notice, I have a legend, I have an x-axis label, a y-axis label, and a title. Need all those things. Without those things, you'll lose points. So with my table highlighted, I'm just going to copy it, jump out of here, go back over here, and if you notice, I've given you a place for a transmittance plot. I am actually going to do, rather than a paste, let's see if I can find it. I guess it's up here. I'm going to do a paste special. So the paste special option here, I am going to choose anything but the Microsoft Excel chart object. So I'm just going to go with a graph object here and say OK. There we go. And if you notice, the plot has gone into the document. I'm going to make it a little bit bigger for you here. And actually, I'm going to make it a little smaller. If you notice, it's about half a size of the page. That's the size we want it. Please don't make them smaller. We can't see them. So we like them that size. Let me put that back where it belongs. So over here, we still have a couple more plots to make. I will leave those up to you. You can sort of do the same thing. I can try that I did. That will get you your plots of opacity and density. You'll need to make those as well. So hopefully this was helpful to everyone, and you can come back here and use this as a reference for the rest of the semester.